about the modular homes versus trailers. Number one, does everybody in the council know the correct definition between the two? Okay? If you don't...
I've done some research on it, yes.
Okay, well, what's your definition?
Well, the phrase...
You'd have to go by the ordinance that's already been established in the book and actually read him all of that, because there's a definition for modular home in our ordinance, as well as mobile home.
Has it been updated? Has it been updated? Because all modular and trailers and modular homes are built in a factory, okay? One has a steel beam as its major strength, and the other ones are brought in pieces and shipped just like a trailer. One comes with wheels, the other comes on a trailer with wheels, a truck. And then they're put together at the site on a foundation. And also, if you have a trailer, you can do the same thing and beat the ordinance unless you write it very particular and peculiar to that, to the what the person is trying to do, because they can take the trailer off the wheels and put it on a slab or put it on cinder blocks, and they can beat what you write, because it's got, you have to be real legal.
I don't have the book in front of me, but it's actually included and capitulated in that Unicode. And I do know that when Mr. Mike Ragusa was mayor here, mm-hmm. he introduced that for those reasons with specificity, and he and I, along with his education as far as building and his contractual work, mm-hmm. we put together that statutory authority and wrote that ordinance. So I have to pull that out and actually read you that definition, but it is, which, now I have not been here for the last 6 or 7 years. I don't know if y'all changed it.
Well, can the public get a copy of that?
Absolutely. It's okay. An ordinance that's on file with the clerk.
Okay.
I don't have a copy with me tonight.
Okay, no, that's fine.
It's in there. I mean, okay. We all have a copy of it.
Okay, and the other thing is, that has to take place. If someone has a home built in an area where they say there's a lot around it, that somebody could petition the city to put their modular home there, okay? My particular property and others around me was built in 1914, and it's still here today. And it cost a lot of money to renovate it, cost a lot of money to keep it up. And when you're retired, you don't get raises every 6 years or every year. So I'm concerned about the devaluation of my property. And you can add to the ordinance, if that's going to occur, that the city will reimburse the party who's next or near the modular homes that dropped the value, pay me the difference in the value.
I've been a resident here about 26 years. I live on Damiano on the old Navarre Trailers property. My concerns are the same as that gentleman right there. Read in the paper that Angelo had an idea maybe to do some modular homes, might make the city a little better. I can't figure out why. If people want to live here, why don't they build a house? Not much difference. And a modular home, like that gentleman says, a trailer. You can BS anybody you want. It's made at the same factory, it's on wheels, and it's mobile. I don't think the city needs that. I've spent an awful lot of money where I live. Got a nice house, big piece of property. I maintain it, and I'm more concerned about the corner of Gazzardo and Kent, that a few years ago there was a movement trying to get trailers put there. Campo owns that property, and he's got a trailer court down the road a little bit. Now, I'm not close enough to reject that. I'm not in a 300-foot zone that you have to be, so that you know. But I do live next to those 8 trailers that Navarre Trailers owns, and not very nice. I pick up trash every day in front of my house. If you go down Damiano, when you make the turn off of Gazzarda, it looks like a dump. The people come home from work, they throw their garbage in the street right there. The city tries to keep up with it, but they, you know, it's tough. And I just don't understand why we need to do anything like that. This is a nice little town. I moved away from Metairie to come here so it would be more peaceful. I just don't understand. Is there some money involved? Will the city gain more tax money by doing this? Or what could be the reason? understand there's an ordinance on trailers, because right at the corner, well, there was a guy was cleaning everything up, and he was going to move his trailer there. And I stopped at City Hall. I said, "Will this guy get approval to put the trailer there?" And they said, "No, nobody knows too much about it." But that's what his plan was. But he never put it there because evidently he came to City Hall, and they told him, you know, that there's a moratorium on trailers.
We're not allowing trailers in the city.
Right. And my thoughts were, because I was a builder. I was a builder for 42 years. I built houses. And for me, a trailer and a modular home, you can say whatever you want. They're the same thing. Made at the same factory. And if you buy a decent enough modular home, I think you can afford to buy a house. You can put a small house. They're talking about 16. Jimmy's talking about 1,600 square feet. You know, the property value in Independence is really hard right now. We can't seem to get any value out of our property. And I just don't feel like this would help us in any way.
Okay, I heard earlier that someone was saying that a modular home and a mobile home are the same thing. They're not. Years ago, a 14 by 80 mobile home weighed about 36,000 pounds. A modular home the same size weighed 80,000 pounds. It had hardy board siding, 9-foot ceilings, hardwood floors, very well constructed. Some of the positives of a modular home were they do maintain their value. They can be insured just like a regular home. Allstate verified that. And they must meet all the building codes that a regular home would go through. They must meet those same standards. I spoke with the tax assessor, Junior Matthews, and I spoke with two real estate agents. And I asked about property values going down. And they said it's like a family reunion, it's all relative. Some of these areas in town would probably increase the value if you had a nice modular home on them, because some of them don't look like modular homes. But some areas, for example, the best example I can find for you is on Redbird Lane. You got a $350,000 home, you got a couple lots. You got the Abdallah house, probably worth in the $200 range. You got Mary Dernan's house, which is worth $299. And then Susan and Andy Carter just bought Sal Dixon's home. And I'm sure they paid over $200 for it. And across the street, you got John Hardy and M's house, which I would say is probably in the $200,000 range. Susie and Andy Carter told me that they would have never ever purchased that home had there been a modular home anywhere around it. Now, we've talked about prices, and some people can't afford a house. Well, let's just look at this first one here. This is a 14 by 80. It's 1,280 square feet. If you bought a mobile home that size, which we don't allow mobile homes, of course, it'd be $68,000. A modular home that same size would cost you $80,000, which would be $62.50 a square foot. Okay, if you go to the next example, you see the double wide, and the Clayton homes they have mostly mobile homes, but any floor plan on the lot can be turned into a modular home. And it takes about 3 or 4 months. So you're not really saving with time. But if you look at this double wide, it's 1,800 square feet. And that comes out to $80.56 a foot because it cost $145,000. Now you could buy probably 3/4 of the houses in Independence for $145,000. Now, if you look at First Guarantee Bank on financing such a home, the first thing they do is they require, whether it's residential, I have here for you, a statement on residential and commercial value. The residential, notice it has to be immobilized, which means the wheels have to come off. I think Larry had talked about putting restrictions about maybe putting it having to be on a slab. Right? Larry, am I correct? So if you immobilize it and remove the wheels, then you have to almost have a slab to put it on. You have to own the piece of property that you're putting it on if you want First Guaranty Bank, and I know there's other lending institutions to finance this. They are only willing to finance if it's brand new 75%. So let's go to this $145,000 home. The bank would only finance $108,750. You would have to have $36,250 in your pocket, not to mention closing costs, plus, like Larry said, let's put some restrictions on it. So you would have to have probably close to $50,000 in cash.
Plus just the land.
Plus the land.
Plus you have to own the property for Guaranty Bank to do that. That's on the residential side. On the commercial side, they only lend you 70% of the appraised value, and it has to be a minimum of 7 years old or they won't lend you the money. And it's the same thing, even if you bought that 14 by 80, you can see that the bank would finance $60,000 of that. It's 1,280 square feet at $62 a square foot, and then you'd have to own the property. Plus, you'd have to have $20,000 closing costs and any restrictions on top of that. So the idea of you giving a young couple a chance to buy a home or get in a first-time home, I don't see it.
No, we have plenty of homes in town that's $56,000.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Then, you know,
have a note for $500 a month.
Right. And so I don't see where you gaining now that, or if you remember years ago, Gary Oglesby was one of the first ones that wanted to bring a modular home into town. And he was denied. Also, the health unit that was just built outside of town was wanted to originally locate next behind the Piggly Wiggly. They were denied. Four of you people sitting here tonight were on that board that said no, they couldn't come here, and that hadn't been but a few years ago. The other thing I'm concerned about is there are several people that own considerable tracts of land, 7.5, 8 acres. What's to keep them from subdividing it into lots and letting people put modular homes on it? And the average person cannot drive down the street and say, wait a minute, they got a trailer here? Oh, no, that's a modular home. Years ago, Ken actually did the advertisement for them. They started on 442, a double-wide mobile home park in the LaRonja area, and it was in the Robert LaRonja School District, which is, quote, the best one. The starting price was around $68,000. They had to sit on 1 acre lots. So you would think, wow, man, being in LaRonja on an acre. Today, you can buy 25 or 30 of those homes in that same subdivision for $20,000-$25,000, because I know people that bought them. So I don't know how this ordinance, there are certain places in town that I think would benefit from them. But how are you going to sit here and require or say, yeah, you can build it because you live over here, but you can't build it because you live over here? And then the other thing, Larry, when you talked about the restriction of putting a slab, then what do you mean a slab? A driveway slab or a house slab, which we're talking about a lot of money difference. In addition to that, who's going to monitor or who's going to see that the code is enforced on those restrictions for that slab? We're going to be responsible for that if we're requiring it. So are we going to have to pay someone to do that? So at this time, after doing this amount of research, I don't, unless you can cordon off certain areas that they're allowed, and then you're probably going to get sued if you try to do that. But I would hate to see, for example, across from the high school on Whitetail Street. Angela, help me out.
Ragusa Road.
Ragusa Road, okay. There's a nice piece of property right next to the Capadonas. Someone could easily buy that 5 acres and say, okay, I'm going to put me a road down it. I'm going to sell the correct size lots, and we would have what would look like a mobile home, and yet we would say, no, they're modular homes. The average person, like I said, Susie and Andy Carter, who are really nice people, said they would never, ever considered buying a house on Redbird Lane had there been a modular home on it.
That other street you're talking about there on Goose Grove is outside the city limits.
Oh, that is outside the city limits, so that would be okay.
Well,
I also talked to Paul Dernan, who owns 7.5 acres that is in town.
Yeah, it is in town.
And he was originally, he had a $500,000 plan to build a home. I saw the blueprints, but now he's considering just buying his dad's place. Well, he could put a street down it and sell the lots, the regular size, legal lots, and put a modular home park up in town, and I don't see how that's going to help our property values. And like I said, as far as, you know, Calvin, I appreciate your argument of trying to help young people get into a home, but when you look at these figures,
yeah.
I mean, it's a long way from being affordable. You could buy half the houses Independence for that, and $80 a square foot. Mike, John Horty, some of you people that are in the building industry, you could subcontract the home and probably get it for in the neighborhood of $60-$65 a square foot, and here you're paying $80 for this. So that's all I had to say. Thank you.
Right.